So welcome to this video. I'm Ian Gilfillan from the MariaDB Foundation, and this video looks at the three set operators: union, intersect, and accept. Basically, they all do similar things. They take two result sets and combine them in some other way. So the video assumes you know some basic SQL, but not necessarily how to use these three and what the differences between them are. So to test it and to make it easy to follow, we're going to create a single table with one field in. So we're going to create table T with a single field I and insert some values into it. It's going to be a numeric integer, and we're going to insert the values 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, and 4. We'll see why the duplicates are important in a little while. Now, again, to make it easy to follow, the query on the left will always be the same. It's going to be select I from T, where I is less than or equal to 3. So it's always going to return the result, the results 1, 2, 2, and 3, 3. Again, the query on the right will also be the same throughout all of these examples, and it's going to be select I from T, where I is greater than or equal to 3. So it's always going to be returning the results 3, 3, and 4. So let's start with union, which has been around the longest. Union essentially combines everything from the left and the right results, creating a union of the two result sets. So if we go select I from T, where I is less than or equal to 3, union, select I from T, where I is greater than or equal to 3, we get the results 1, 2, 3, and 4. So basically everything has been returned. It's a combination of the two. Now you might ask, why are there no duplicates? What happened to the 2, 2 and the 3, 3? Well, union by default removes all duplicates. There's in fact a keyword you can add next to union to specify that. You can say union distinct to the same query, and you will get the identical results back. So distinct is the default behavior. Duplicates are removed. If you don't want duplicates to be removed, then you can use the all keyword. So replace distinct with all, and now we get the results 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3, and 4. So there are four instances of 3 because there are 2 from the left result and 2 from the right result. So that's union. Intersect was introduced in MariaDB 10.3. An intersect looks at the overlap or the intersection between the two result sets. So if we go select I from T, where I is less than or equal to 3, intersect, select I from T, where I is greater than or equal to 3, we get the result 3. So 3 is the only thing that they have in common, the only overlapping result. Again, duplicates have been removed, so we've essentially said intersect distinct. Now, distinct and all were introduced in MariaDB 10.5, sorry. So from that version, you can now say same query, and you can say intersect all, and you will get the duplicate 3 and 3 returned. So the final one is accept. Accept takes everything on the left side, except for what's also in the right side. So it's essentially a subtraction between the two result sets. So if we try it out, select I from T, where I is less than or equal to 3, except, select I from T, where I is greater than or equal to 3, we will get the results 1 and 2. So 3 is held in common, therefore it's removed, and we only get 1 and 2 from the left result set. Again, duplicates are removed. So if we use the distinct keyword, we will get the exact same results. That's the default behavior. Or we can replace it with the all keyword. So select I from T, where I is less than or equal to 3, accept all, the rest of the query. And now we will get 1 and 2, 2. So duplicates 2, duplicates are returned. And that's it. Very quick introduction to the three set operators. Hope you enjoyed the video. There is more information below in the YouTube description with links to our knowledge base with more examples and further descriptions. If you wish, please subscribe to our MariaDB Foundation YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Till next time.